This week, again, you can be a helper. And just like last week, you can help own the tone in America. And you can do that by taking a minute to understand why the hell we have off on Monday from work, school, etc. You can go to history.com or go to the Department of Labor website and share a few nuggets of info with your family and friends, or explain it to the kids in the car this weekend. Because just like Memorial Day, Labor Day is and should be more than just about a mattress sale. It's about something really important. Work, 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 work. It's to me, I'll be work, 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 work. You see me do me there, 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 there. It's something about that work, 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 work. When you walk along. So on Monday, September 2nd, 2019, America will celebrate and honor the greatest workers in the world, the American worker. And Labor Day 2019 is actually the 125th anniversary of Labor Day, being celebrated as a national holiday. Now, what does it mean? Labor Day is the first Monday in September, and it's a creation of the labor movement and dedicated to the social and economic achievements of the American workers. It constitutes a yearly national tribute to the contributions workers have made to the strength, prosperity, and well-being of our country. The first governmental recognition came through some municipal ordinances that passed back in 1885 and 1886. For these, a movement developed to secure state legislation, and the first state to introduce it was New York, the great Empire State. The first to become law was passed by Oregon on February 21st, 1887. During 1887, four more states, Colorado, Massachusetts, New Jersey, and New York, created the Labor Day holiday by legislative enactment. But by the end of the decade, Connecticut, Nebraska, Pennsylvania had all followed. And by 1894, 23 more states had adopted the holiday. And on June 28, 1894, Congress passed an act making the first Monday in September of each year a legal holiday in the District of Columbia and the territories. More than a century after the first Labor Day observance, there's still some doubt as to who first proposed the holiday for workers. Now, some records show that Peter J. McGuire, the General Secretary of the Brotherhood of the Carpenters and Joiners and a co-founder of the American Federation of Labor, was first in suggesting a day to honor, quote, who from rude nature have delved and carved all the grandeur we behold. That's a great quote, right? But Peter McGuire's place in Labor Day history has not gone unchallenged, because this is the labor movement after all, right? Many believe that Matthew McGuire, a machinist, not Peter McGuire, founded the holiday. Now, recent research seems to support the contention that Matthew McGuire, later the secretary of Local 344 of the International Association of Machinists in Paterson, New Jersey, proposed the holiday in 1882 while he was serving as the secretary of the Central Labor Union in New York. What is clear is that the Central Labor Union adopted a Labor Day proposal and appointed a committee to plan a demonstration and a picnic. But the first Labor Day, the first one, was celebrated on Tuesday, September 5th, 1882, in New York City, in accordance with the plans of that Central Labor Union. The Central Labor Union held its second Labor Day holiday just a year later, on September 5th, 1883. And by 1894, 23 states had adopted the holiday. And on June 28th, 1894, President Grover Cleveland signed a law making the first Monday in September of each year a national holiday. Now, the form that the observance and celebration of Labor Day should take was outlined in the first proposal of the holiday. It didn't have mattress sales. It said a street parade to exhibit to the public, quote, the strength and esprit de corps of the trade and labor organizations, unquote, of the community, followed by a festival for recreation and amusement of the workers and their families. Now, this became the pattern for celebrations of Labor Day. Speeches by prominent people came later, and an emphasis on the economic and civic significance of the holiday. And still later, by a resolution of the American Federation of Labor Convention of 1909, the Sunday preceding Labor Day was adopted as Labor Sunday and dedicated to the spiritual and educational aspects of the labor movement. Now, the character of Labor Day has changed in recent years, especially in big industrial centers where mass displays and huge parades were kind of a problem. This change, however, is more a shift in emphasis and medium of expression. Labor Day addresses by leading union officials, industrialists, educators, clerics, and government officials are given wide coverage in newspapers, radio, and television. but the vital force of labor added materially to the highest standard of living and the greatest production the world has ever known. And it's brought us closer to the realization of the traditional ideals of economic and political democracy. It's pretty appropriate, then, that our nation pays tribute to Labor Day and to the creator of so much of our nation's strength, freedom, and leadership, the American worker, the real American worker. That's many of you. So raise a glass this weekend to the American worker. And if that includes you, raise one to yourself. So that's my homework for this week. Read a little bit, share a little bit, and drink a little bit. Raise a glass to yourself and to others. And if you've got a story to tell or a resource to share, find us on social media, use the hashtag #AngryAmericans, and let me know. Don't just be angry. Be active. Get to work.
Work, 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 work. You see me, I be work, 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 work. You see me, do me, da, 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 da. Tell me about that work, work, work.